SpaceX has yet to begin static fire testing on S39 due to unforeseen complications. Simultaneously, Blue Origin achieved unexpected success with the long-awaited New Shepard NS-35 mission. Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. SpaceX once again captured the public's attention when S38, the final Starship V2 model, was recently transported to the launch pad for static fire evaluation using specialized test equipment. The schedule was carefully structured, featuring a scheduled time slot from early morning to late afternoon on September 18th, with a second opportunity available from early morning to late afternoon on the 19th. These two intervals were designated for conducting initial engine tests, followed by full ignition of all six engines. The highly anticipated first test began on the 18th. The day began with significant activity in the storage tank, which indicated significant exhaust emissions as operations began. The engine platform was lowered and undocked from the orbital launch site, while engineers checked the S-38's cowling to ensure its readiness, climbing into position as the spacecraft's quick-release arm self-locked. Furthermore, the catastrophic explosion prevention system underwent testing, demonstrating that SpaceX was following its usual checklist and that everything was proceeding as anticipated. As preparations progressed, the release of exhaust gases at the launch site signaled the start of fueling. During this phase, the primary visual indicator everyone expected was the appearance of frost accumulation on the sides of the S-38 tank, which would verify the presence of cryogenic fuel. Unfortunately, no frost appeared. Shortly thereafter, exhaust filling at the orbital launch site ceased, and there was still no indication of propellant in the tank. A brief resumption of exhaust flow signaled the second attempt, but the results remained the same. Instead of frost, heavier vents on the sides indicated frost. By then, it became clear that the first static fire test attempt had ended in complete chaos. Unsurprisingly, the immediate question was why it had failed. Observers noted that the problem appeared to be related to the fuel lines. A blockage, damage, or malfunction may have prevented the fuel from reaching the spacecraft completely. Another potential issue was that the pumps, vital for propellant transfer, were not operating properly. Given that no frost was observed on the methane or liquid oxygen tanks, the most reasonable conclusion is that no fuel was ever loaded. The underlying cause could stem from a variety of factors, but one possible aspect is the stress exerted on the system during recent thruster testing. Thrust operations require the fuel system to operate at extremely high speeds, which can lead to wear and tear and unforeseen issues. Furthermore, each time SpaceX transitions from thruster evaluation to ship assessment, engineers need to adjust the fuel line connections to match the ship's test system. Such modifications add complexity and the risk of pump or connection malfunctions. Similar incidents have occurred before. The initial launch attempt for Flight 10 was aborted due to a ground system error, highlighting that difficulties often stem from ground infrastructure, not the spacecraft itself. This scenario once again illustrates that while the ship's test system is an excellent short-term fix that allows Starship to continue operations, it also creates new challenges. For continued reliability, it is crucial to reactivate the Molesi test site as soon as possible. This facility will allow for more consistent and efficient operations and reduce the likelihood of recurring issues on the launch pad. However, the recent issue does not appear to be severe. SpaceX ground crews have the expertise to quickly identify and repair the issue. Repairs or modifications will likely be made soon to restore the system to operational condition. With the cancellation of the September 18th test, the focus now shifts to the next date when SpaceX plans to conduct a single engine test. If this test is successful, the new schedule will likely set the 20th as the date for a full 6-engine static test. This evaluation is a critical step in ensuring Starship's readiness for future missions. If the test goes smoothly, S-38 will soon be transported back to the production facility for final inspection and installation tasks. Given the rapid preparation observed for S-37, it is reasonable to anticipate S-38 returning to the pad later this month for stacking. Meanwhile, B-15 has been at the production site for some time and is expected to have completed its internal assessment. The addition of a flight termination system and hot staging equipment is anticipated soon. Once the ship's test system is removed from the launch pad and the smaller auxiliary systems are reinstalled, B-15 can return to the launch pad to prepare for stacking with S-38. The one-day delay in testing, while unfortunate, will not drastically impact the overall Starship timeline. The potential for a late September launch remains, although early October may be more likely. However, if Flight 11 can lift off before October 3rd, it would surpass the record 37-day wait time between Flights 5 and 6, demonstrating not only SpaceX's increasing momentum, but also the benefit of insights gained from the success of Flight 10. However, careful planning should always be a top priority. A successful 11th flight will not only confirm the improvements made to the heat shield and other systems, but it will also lay the groundwork for the next generation V3 vehicle. This will build confidence in the program and help maintain the forward momentum Starship needs to achieve its ambitious goals. Do you agree that prioritizing thorough preparation is more important than rushing to achieve records? Share your thoughts in the comments with a yes or no, along with your predictions for when the 11th flight will launch. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's incredible journey. With that in mind, testing is again a top priority. The upcoming S38 test will not only complete preparations for the 11th flight, but will also be the final test conducted on Pad 1 in its current state. After the 11th flight is complete, SpaceX intends to deconstruct and renovate Pad 1, bringing it up to par with the more advanced V2 model. Pad 1 has been a landmark in Starship's development trajectory. From the start, the pad faced challenges, particularly during Flight 1, but continuous improvements followed each challenge. Over time, it evolved into a robust and reliable platform. Critical systems such as the water-cooled armor plates, orbital launch mount, suction cups, and quick disconnect for the craft have all performed exceptionally well. Pad 1 has played a crucial role in many of Starship's significant milestones, culminating in the memorable moments when SpaceX conducted ambitious Super Heavy intercept operations. However, as impressive as Pad 1 is, it cannot be the bedrock of Starship's activity forever. Starship's future will require greater strength, more frequent launches, and greater resilience. This is why Pad 1 is now undergoing reconstruction to effectively prepare for the next operational phase. Meanwhile, Pad 2 has taken on a leading role. In conjunction with the latest S38 test campaign, SpaceX is examining the water deluge system within the Pad 2 fire trench. Unlike previous tests, which produced only light spray, this latest demonstration produced a powerful spray visible from a distance. This likely indicates that the system is functioning at full capacity. This system is designed to withstand the intense heat and pressure generated during booster tests and official launches. The combination of the jet system and fire trench design is critical to safely managing these forces and preserving the pad infrastructure. Further testing on Pad 2 is expected in the coming weeks to validate its readiness before becoming a primary launch site. The countdown has begun, as B-18 has reportedly completed its stacking and will soon begin cryogenic testing. Once the engines are installed, B-18 may be ready for static fire tests in late October or early November. This indicates that all critical systems on Pad 2 must be fully operational by then. The coming months are expected to be crucial for Pad 2. And this shift represents a significant milestone in SpaceX's development. The foundation has been laid for a future filled with more powerful, faster, and more frequent Starship launches. The pressing question is, are you ready for this exciting new phase? Meanwhile, on the other side of the pond, Blue Origin's New Shepard mission. The NS-35 mission, originally planned to launch alongside SpaceX Flight 10, has experienced several delays due to issues with the booster's avionics system. In an unexpected announcement, Blue Origin has successfully completed its flight. The launch took place at 9:01 a.m. Eastern Time from the company's West Texas site. The mission was a complete success, with the booster and capsule separating and landing without complications, demonstrating that previous technical challenges had been overcome. While the event received less attention because it was purely a cargo mission, the NS-35 carried 40 scientific payloads, 24 of which were for NASA. The flight also marked a milestone, bringing the total number of payloads flown on New Shepard to over 200. However, Blue Origin still faces significant challenges ahead. While New Shepard continues to serve as a suborbital research platform, the company's long-term reputation hinges heavily on the success of New Glenn, its orbital-class rocket. The New Glenn launch has yet to occur, despite its highly anticipated debut, originally scheduled for earlier this year. For now, the NS-35 represents a promising development, but all eyes are on how quickly Blue Origin can transition from suborbital to orbital capabilities. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.